Okay, so Azure Machine Learning is awesome. I'm going to show you how it works today, help you get a new instance set up, and just really show you the ropes. So stick around. Hi, I'm Matt Eland. I'm a software engineering instructor during the day, but in the evenings, I get to play with machine learning and all that really fun data science-y stuff. And I want to show you today just the best way I found to work with machine learning. And that's Azure's machine learning. So Azure is Microsoft's cloud offering, and they have some machine learning offerings there that are really good for you no matter what level of experience you have with data science, including none whatsoever. You might think I'm joking there, but just keep watching. It's really cool. So Azure Machine Learning allows you to run machine learning experiments in the cloud. You get to track the results of your experiments, including the trained models in Azure Storage, which is very minimally priced. You get to really evaluate and explain those models using Microsoft's really custom-built software for it. The nice thing about it, the thing I love about it, is how accessible it is. And you're going to see what I mean just as we kind of take a look around Azure Machine Learning a little bit more. But if you're curious about this, you can take a look at the URL here. Go take a look at the features. I really recommend setting up a free account if you haven't don't have an Azure account already, because it's going to give you all sorts of features and really a lot of free stuff for a full year and additional credits before then. So you can really take a look at some of the massive amounts of free offerings they have. But let's get into the details. So here I am in my Azure dashboard, and I have some things set up already, but I want to add a new Azure Machine Learning instance. So I'm going to go to my resources list, and I'm going to say create a resource. And it's going to give me an ability to search things. I can also click on AI and Machine Learning at the very top of the category list. And actually, Machine Learning right there is the one I want. So I can click on it, and it'll give you a little bit more details about that service. Actually, it goes on into create the service. So if you're not familiar with this kind of a page before, we have the ability to create, to set things inside of resource groups to set up the details of it. I'm going to create a new resource group here to represent this. I'm going to call this on my end, Intro to Azure ML. You can call it whatever you want if you're following along. And I'm going to call this Matt on Data Science Test. Created in North Central US, and notice that it creates a new storage account, Azure Key Vault, and Application Insights instance for me. You can pick whatever region is closest to you. North Central US is in Iowa, I believe, and that's fairly near to me. But it needs a storage account to store the results of the model runs. It needs a Key Vault to store all sorts of authentication credentials that it uses for its internal workings. And it also uses Application Insights instances for tracking deployed models and maybe some other things as well. It does have the option to create a container registry. That's one of those things that I would recommend you defer until later on, because you do pay for that if you're on a paid subscription, and you only need it really if you're deploying a model. So you don't really necessarily need it to check it out. You can take a look at the networking and advanced tabs if you want, as well as set tags if you want to add some custom tags. But I'm just going to go ahead and review and create. And it's going to validate my configuration. It says it's good. And so I'm going to go ahead and click create. And that should be submitted and operational pretty soon here, actually. And we'll just catch you as soon as it's ready. All right, so that took a grand total of 2 minutes for me. And so it really is that quick to create one. It creates only a few things, and once it's done, you can click on Go to Resource, and it'll take you right to that page. This is a fairly standard page looking at details. You can take a look at configuration for this. It looks very similar to an app service if you're familiar with those in Azure. But really, the first thing you want to do is take note of this download config.json link here. That's going to be important later on if you start using the Python SDK, because you can actually write Python code on your own machine and connect to your Azure instance and just use it to track experiments or use cloud computing resources there. We're not going to mess with that today, but that is an important feature to be aware of. So I'm going to go ahead and click Launch Studio, and it's going to open me up to a new URL here. All right, so this is the Azure Machine Learning Studio, or AMLS for short. This is a really involved user interface for machine learning professionals or data scientists. From here, you can run experiments, you can track your data, you can take a look at the Azure compute and storage resources that are assigned to you, as well as deploy machine learning resources so that other people can call them and get good results from experiments you've already completed. So there's a lot of stuff you can do here. We'll look at this in more detail in a future video, but just a key level thing for you to understand here is that this has something for everybody. If you're an experienced machine learning professional, you can take advantage of its ability to just track your experiments. You can run your experiments locally and just upload the results automatically using the SDK. If you kind of know what you're doing, you can take advantage of the drag and drop capabilities of the designer to really just arrange whatever nodes you want to form a functioning machine learning pipeline. And that might include some custom code nodes as well. If you're very new to machine learning, then automated ML is going to be the thing for you. So automated ML, or auto ML for short, is going to really have Azure's algorithms try out your machine learning tasks and figure out what parameters work well, what types of machine learning algorithms work, and kind of present the results to you. So you can do data science even if you don't know the difference between a random forest and a decision tree, for example. So expect some future videos from here for my channel on this topic. So make sure you like and subscribe for that. But you now have an Azure Machine Learning Studio instance up and running, and you can play around with it as you'd like. So happy coding, and let me know what you built.